All creations made by man have fallen to Mother Nature. Submarines, the large metallic tube that descends deep into ocean's depths, are no exception. The news of the Titanic-bound submarine Titan's implosion due to immense oceanic pressure at a depth of 3.8 kilometers is terrifying. To add to the terror, we are looking to do a deeper dive. Have you ever wondered what happens to the human body when a submarine implodes? It's a topic that sends shivers down your spine and leaves you in awe of the immense forces involved. The answer is a horrifying one, where the body is crushed by the water, and this all happens in an instant, so fast that people don't even experience any pain. So how does this water do it? And how does it do it so fast? You see, when a submarine implodes, it happens at a jaw-dropping speed. Imagine the hull moving inward at an astonishingly rate of approximately 1,500 miles per hour or 2,200 feet per second. To put this into perspective, a modern nuclear submarine's hull radius is around 20 feet. Thus, the time required for complete collapse is a mind-blowing 1 millisecond. Yes, you heard that right. Everything happens in a mere blink of an eye. Anything smaller than that would get crushed even faster. Human response versus implosion speed. Our human brains are remarkable organs capable of processing stimuli and responding instinctually. However, compared to the lightning-fast implosion of a submarine, our rational response simply cannot keep up. While our brain instinctually responds to stimuli at a relatively rapid pace of 25 milliseconds, the complete sense-to-reason-to-action process takes about 150 milliseconds at best. The colossal implosion happens in a fraction of that time, leaving little room for any conscious reaction. The recent incident has brought a huge spotlight on oceanography and the question of what happens to the human body in an implosion. According to the Oxford Dictionary, an implosion can be defined as the act of collapsing into the center. In an explosion, materials are dispersed outwards, but in an implosion, the objects are forced inwards. An example of it would be a crushed can, which is pushed inwards. It is compression caused by some force acting from the outside. For example, when you crush a can with your fist pushing it inside. In this clip, oceanic pressure destroys the monster can and crushes it inwards. Now we understand what an implosion is. But what is this ocean pressure, the mysterious force which does not allow humans to explore the depths of the oceans? Ocean pressure refers to the force exerted by the weight of water in the ocean. As you go deeper into the ocean, the weight of the water above you increases, causing the pressure to rise. This pressure can be quite high in the deep parts of the ocean. In simple terms, ocean pressure is the squeezing force that water exerts on objects underwater due to the weight of the water above them. The deeper all objects go, oceanic pressure pushes everything being inwards their center from all sides. With all the gear and breathing gases, humans can go as deep as 500 meters, though this has never been done for safety purposes and has only been simulated. Without high-tech gear, humans can only go as deep as 60 meters, which is nothing since the average depth of the ocean is 3,688 meters. This sheds light on how dangerous deep-water oceans are. Oceanic pressure can be calculated using the equation of pressure equals depth multiplied by gravity and density of the water. The unit commonly used to measure oceanic pressure is the decibar. The decibar is a unit of pressure equal to 1/10 of a bar, which is approximately equal to the atmospheric pressure at sea level. It is often used in oceanography and marine sciences to express water pressure at different depths in the ocean. The Mariana Trench reaches a depth of approximately 11,000 meters, where the pressure is equivalent to 1,086 bars or 15,750 psi. To grasp the magnitude of this pressure, imagine the sensation of having 100 elephants standing on your head. That is the pressure one would feel at that ocean depth. Now we understand the force that caused the submarine's implosion. We can now put a microscope on the incident. The explosion within. As the submarine's hull collapses, the air trapped inside behaves like an engine piston. The sudden compression of air causes auto ignition, resulting in a devastating explosion. The point failure propagates, and the surrounding water rushes in at tremendous speeds. Under hundreds of tons of pressure per square meter, the water compresses the air inside the submarine, leading to increased temperatures. Inside a submarine, hydraulic oil, diesel oil from auxiliary engines, kitchen oils, grease, rubber, and plastics release hydrocarbon vapors into the sub's atmosphere that explode instantly. What happens to humans inside the sub? The answer is quite horrifying and relieving at the same time. At a depth of 3.8 kilometers, the oceanic pressure would be about 6,000 pounds per inch. By doing the math and comparing it to the average human body, the approximate pressure that the passengers felt was about 18 million pounds of pressure per inch. When numbers are this high, they tend to lose meaning. What that would feel like is a tube of toothpaste being crushed by a hydraulic press. If the submersible were to undergo a sudden implosion, the consequences for the human body inside would be catastrophic. The abrupt compression of the surrounding environment would result in the immediate and severe crushing of the individual's body. This process would occur within a fraction of a second due to the substantial and immediate change in pressure. The compression would affect various parts of the body containing gas, such as the lungs and gastrointestinal tract, causing them to collapse or implode. Additionally, the water pressure would force water into body cavities like the nose, mouth, and ears. These rapid changes in pressure could lead to significant internal injuries, including bleeding and organ damage. One of the upsides, if there is one, given the rapidity of the implosion, it is unlikely that an individual would experience considerable pain. Most human tissues are fluid-filled and are, for the most part, incompressible. Human lungs and sinuses will be crushed instantly, and the immense shock would render them unconscious almost instantly due to the extreme trauma and lack of oxygen, and the people wouldn't even know about it. The deaths are instantaneous and painless. Regarding the visual aspects, the implosion would generate a powerful shockwave in the water, resulting in a sudden cloud of debris comprising the destroyed submersible and, sadly, the remnants of the occupant. Subsequently, the water would swiftly rush back into the void, further contributing to the chaotic scene. Now, the final question that we arrive at is, what happened to the bodies of the passengers? Where did all the bodies go, or at least their remains? Firstly, the bodies would go through immense heat. The air bubble created by the submarine will fail, and all the pressure outside is going to compress the air inside, heating up to an excruciatingly hot 10,000 degrees Fahrenheit, or the temperature of the sun. If anything did remain of the bodies, it would be turned into gel and would be ejected at extremely high velocity. The compressed process meant would be ejected outwards, soon to be food of the underwater creatures below. Thanks for watching. If you enjoyed this video, please give it a thumbs up and subscribe to our channel for more content. Until next time, this is Fleet Files, signing off. See you in the next video.